منطلقا جواد الفجر قد حمحم وشد لجامه مسلم كوجه البدر محترقا كرمح النصر منطلقا كموج غاضب غضبا
يا دنيا كريري بديما كجنان الليا غرنام كويتا في دنيا بيبي آدم غمي بلا دي يونتي بلا دي يونتي جلنم سيئتا كي جنغ جنغ الدنيا مين كوي منو دي بلا كريلي كوي بيدي ما هيجي If you are the man, come
It was a creed written into the founding documents that declared the destiny of the nation.
The road, 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 the road,
Jones,
Osama bin Laden is not an easy subject. Characterizations of him vary wildly. The most common, because it's the official narrative of cardboard cutout simplicity, is that he's the world's number one villain, the diabolical mastermind behind the events of September 11th. Another view, Osama is the conscience of Islam. Well, globally, Osama is like a Rorschach inkblot. His character and role morph into what various publics project upon him, based on what they're led to believe. Take books. There's an adage you can't tell a book by its cover. Maybe so, but you can tell it by its index. Bin Laden, the man who declared war on America, is by Yosef Budansky, former senior consultant to the Pentagon and U.S. State Department. Budansky explains a vast global conspiracy, it says in the foreword.
Just a joke or playing into fears? A campaign ad is causing a buzz on the internet. CNN's David Mattingly with the story.
When you listen to this John McCain ad, it might sound like Barack Obama has a messiah complex.
You will experience an epiphany, and you will say to yourself, I have to vote for Barack.
The McCain campaign says it's all in good fun.
Behold his mighty hand!
But not everyone's laughing. Some Democrats say the ad, which appears only on the internet, is infused with hidden messages to evangelical Christians. Messages that Barack Obama isn't the Messiah at all.
It reinforces things that they've been hearing around the internet, that maybe Barack Obama is, in fact, the Antichrist.
The ad's been viewed 1.2 million times on YouTube. A Google search for Obama and Antichrist returns an incredible 900,000 hits. One website is completely dedicated to the question, is Obama the Antichrist? 73% of the site's online poll say either yes or maybe. Could the McCain ad be saying the same thing?
That in 2008, the world will be blessed. They will call him the One.
Critics accuse the McCain campaign of trying to tap into biblical prophecy to stir evangelical voters, a group McCain has had difficulty reaching.
Going back to the classic Republican playbook of playing to these people's fears, trying to, you know, send a message to these folks that you really need to be careful. You really need to worry about this guy. He literally could be a cosmic Antichrist figure. And for a lot of people, that may sound strange to believe, but there is a significant part of the American community that will take this stuff very seriously.
Democratic Faith Issues consultant Eric Sapp argues the McCain ad borrows ideas and visual imagery from the blockbuster Left Behind series. The books weave a tale of a modern-day Antichrist, a young political leader who rises to power with a message of peace and unity and leads a world religion that proclaims, we are God. That sounds a lot like this Obama clip used in the ad.
We are the ones we've been waiting for.
The McCain campaign says it's just having some fun with what it calls Obama's tendency to get carried away with audacious statements. But since the release of the ad, Obama Antichrist internet traffic is up. Even the authors of the Left Behind books felt they had to speak out because they're seeing that question more and more often. Do they think Obama is the Antichrist? And each time they say the answer is no way.
The Antichrist will not be somebody who is suspected of being the Antichrist by anybody. If half the country thinks that that one of the candidates is the Antichrist, he's not the Antichrist.
A spokesman for the McCain campaign calls the ad lighthearted. One website takes the joke a little further, selling T-shirts and mugs showing the Obama symbol with a pair of horns. We're not sure how the candidate feels about that. We received no reply from the Obama campaign. David Mattingly, CNN, Atlanta.